Good morning. My name is Ralf Friedrichs. I am an addiction recovery coach and a life coach and the host of this show, the Take Your Life Back Today show. Today is Labor Day, September 4th, 2017. I hope you appreciate that God had given you another 86,400 seconds to live on this beautiful earth. Please take a few seconds and thank Him for that privilege. And remember, Labor Day is a dangerous time. There are a lot of drunk drivers out there. Please be careful when you are going around today. I want to talk about dealing with negative people. Negative people, they're like human black holes, which suddenly come out of nowhere and just suck life out of you. And it happens to each and every one of us each and every day. You try to stay positive and remain strong, but their negativity ends up completely draining you of everything positive inside you. You get to feel very exhausted after a while, and you may also start to feel depressed. So what can you do is a question you might be asking. One of the first things to do is to be aware of who are the negative people that are in your life. And this may not be easy for you at first, so here are some things to help you. Where is the negativity coming from is a question that I have to ask you. Do you understand why this person is so negative? Can you maybe try to analyze what's going on in their life? Is it because they hate their job? Are they feeling frustrated in life? Or maybe they feel trapped in their life and they maybe are suffering from a lack of self-esteem. So the only way they can feel powerful is by being negative around you and other people and maybe even hurting others. If you can understand where it's coming from, it's much easier to deal with these negative people. Number two is just smile and remain completely detached. Whenever the negative tirade starts, just smile and don't say anything. Remain completely detached from these people and just keep walking away from them. Simply smile at them over and over again, because I promise you, friends, positivity will breed positivity. Positivity will overcome negativity. Maybe not that negative person will be overcome by your positive attitude, but you will not become negative. Number three is say, now tell me something positive today. When you run into people that are always negative, I mean, we had some family members that always complained about each and everything, no matter if you go to the supermarket, if you watch something on TV, if it was about other relatives, all they had to say was negative things. So what you can say is, if the negative person is someone who only has negative things to say about people and other things, is just say, now tell me something positive. Tell me a positive story from your past. That would throw them into a spiral because they don't know how to respond. And usually, they will suddenly stop being negative. So you put a stop to the negativity in their life. Number four is imagine a bright white light surrounding you. What does that mean, you might ask? Well, friends, let me read it to you. Yes, that might sound silly at first, but if you can do it, it's amazing how much difference it can make. You'll feel that their negativity can touch you, but it cannot touch you, because now you have a force field protecting you. Do you understand? So if you pretend like this great white light around you, it becomes like a force field. Number five, is it a sign? That's a good question. I find the universe uses negative people as a way to get me to move on whenever I'm getting comfortable in any situation whatsoever. Number six question was, what does it say about you? When people are always negative about things around you, what does that say about you? Negative people want to get a reaction out of you, and the only way that they can is to hit your buttons over and over and over again. Be the better person. Be the stronger person. Turn the negativity into a positive sign. Just keep smiling. Negative people are just trying to feel needed. They just feel that if they're negative and always complaining, they're drawing the attention towards them. And they feel that by doing that, all they want is to feel needed. Is listening to the complaints of a negative person your way of feeling valued? Don't be the martyr. Don't start playing into the negative people's field. Does it make you feel needed? Because if it does, then we, my friends, need to talk on the phone at 844-405-HELP. If it does, then you need to start valuing yourself more, and you'll find that you are a creation of God. You are a miracle of God. You are a masterpiece that God had created. If a negative person makes you feel important, then you need to tell yourself, inventory yourself, and start changing your own ways of not just thinking, but acting. Try saying, I love you and thank you and I'm sorry over and over again. To a negative person, those are the words that's almost like the holy water on a possessed person. If a person's constantly negative and constantly complaining to you and constantly saying things in a negative way, by you saying these words, oh, I understand, but you know, I love you and I thank you for being here and I'm sorry you feel that way, they are sooner or later going to run out of negative things to say because you are just feeding them positive things. Thank you. I'm sorry. I love you. The negativity will start disappearing. Number nine is it's not your fault. You may be feeling that you have to solve the problems of these negative peoples in life, but it's not your fault. And to be honest with you, it's not your problem. I understand we all are human. We have compassion and we have empathy towards other people. But if you let the negative people's problems become your problems, your great positive personality and attitude will start changing towards theirs. Be enthusiastic and focus on your own energy each and every day. Look in the mirror and realize that God had created that beautiful masterpiece in you, that miracle that where He has created. And even that negative person that you are dealing with each and every day is a creation of God. This creation of God, that negative person, is just taking that beautiful painting, that masterpiece, that miracle that God had created and destroying themselves. Do not become them. Number 11 was try translating the message. Something I've noticed happen more and more often nowadays is that a lot of people seem to have lost the ability to express their opinion in a polite and constructive way. They come across as mean-spirited and rude. Try translating the message of hope to these people that are so negative. Try translating the message of peace and of love. And you will see that you will transform that negativity, that negative person, into a positive person. And last but not least is take the garbage pledge. And I'm going to read this to you, and I want you both to please write it down. David J. Poley is the author of The Law of Garbage Truck. His belief is that many people are like garbage trucks. They run around full of garbage, full of frustration, full of anger, full of disappointment. As their garbage piles up, they look for a place to dump their garbage from their garbage truck. And if you let them, they'll dump it on you. So when someone wants to dump on you, don't take it personal. Just smile, wave, wish them well, and move on. Believe me, you'll be happier. This is the garbage truck syndrome. Many people are like garbage trucks. Don't be like a garbage truck. They run around full of garbage, full of frustration, full of anger, full of disappointment, full of hate. As their garbage piles up, they look for a place to dump their garbage. Do not become the recipient of another person's garbage truck. Instead, become a recipient of love, peace, and hope. Dealing with negative people, find out where it's coming from. Just smile and remain completely detached from these people. Say, now tell me something positive. Imagine a bright light surrounding you like a force field to protect you from these negative people. Find out if it's a sign by you maybe needing to move on from these negative people. What does it say about you when negative people want a reaction from you? Stay away from that. Do not give them a reaction. Negative people always try to feel needed, and that's why they are so negative. Their self-esteem is deflated. When you're around negative people and they're constantly complaining to you, try saying, I love you, thank you, and I'm sorry, because sooner or later they're going to get tired of your positivity. Remember, when negative people always dump their stuff on you, it's not your fault. Don't take ownership and try to solve their problem. Be enthusiastic and focus on your own energy and eliminate their energy by moving on. Try translating the message of hope, of peace, and love. And last but not least, take the garbage truck pledge. Many people are like garbage trucks. They run around full of garbage, full of frustration, full of anger, full of disappointment. As their garbage piles up, they look for a place to dump their garbage truck, to empty it. Don't be that person. Don't let somebody else's garbage be dumped on you. Instead, please, my friends, stay away from negative people. Start today with a brand new day, Labor Day, September 4th, 2017. And remember, 86,400 seconds was given to you by the Lord Jesus. Ask God each and every day for guidance and direction. Thank God for everything positive in your life, having a relationship, a home, maybe a job, food and health. These are all the things you should be thankful for. And let today be the first day of your new life. Call me at 844-405-HELP, and together you and I will help each other take our lives back. And remember, stay away from the negativity in life. A lot of times when you watch the news, there's a lot of negativity or negative things on there. Separate yourself from the negative and the positive. And I will see you soon again. May God bless you, and we'll talk real soon again. May God bless you.